solving equations with fractions. Professor G. Okay. So equations are something that we do in algebra. We deal with a lot. But you throw fractions in and all of a sudden it's a little worrisome. You got to worry about things like least common denominator and reducing and stuff. And so it tends to be a little bit of error prone. So what I'm going to do today is I'm actually going to show you how to work through some of these either by getting rid of the fractions or using the multiplicative inverse. All right. And so the first one that we're going to use is 5/8 y minus 3/16 equals a -9/16. All right. Now notice that you have common denominators here. So that actually makes the problem a little bit easier, because you don't have to worry about least common denominators because it already has a common denominator. So you can just do this one, do it like normal. And by normal, what I mean is you want to first undo any additions or subtractions with its inverse. So here we have subtract 3/16, so we're going to add. And then the second thing you want to do is undo any multiplication. But this is fraction, so we're going to undo it with division. But what I'm really going to use is the multiplicative inverse. And that's going to make my life a whole lot easier. So I'm going to show you what that looks like. Okay? So when you have a common denominator, just do it like normal. All right? Undo the additions and subtractions first, and then undo your multiplication with a division. But the division that we want to use is the multiplicative inverse, which will make our life a whole lot easier and avoid any complex fractions. Alright, so let's work it out. If you have 5/8 y minus 3/16 is equal to a -9/16. And we already said we're going to add 3/16 to both sides because they have the nice common denominator. Now there's nothing underneath here, so we just want to bring that down. These cancel out because they're additive inverses. This comes down, don't forget your equal sign. All right. And then a -9 + 3 is a -6/16. Now note that this will reduce, and so you should. So a -6/16, 2 goes into both of those, so -6/2 is a -3, and 16/2 is 8. So you end up with 5/8 y is equal to a -3/8. And so how do I figure out what to do now? Well, remember I said this is a multiply, so we're going to undo it with the multiplicative inverse. Now remember, the multiplicative inverse says that any number times its reciprocal is equal to 1. Any number times its reciprocal is equal to 1. Well, I want to get 1y. So I can actually multiply by 5/8 reciprocal 8/5, and that'll give me 1y. And that's because the 8 on the top will reduce to a 1 with the 8 on the bottom, and the 5 on the top reduces to 1 with the 5 on the bottom, and all you're left with is a bunch of 1s. But whatever I do on the left, I got to do on the right. And so I'm going to multiply by the same 8/5 over here. Got to multiply by this guy's reciprocal. Got to multiply by that number over there. So now, of course, now this is very nice because the 8s also reduce to 1s, and that just leaves me with -3/5. And we finished it, and that makes us happy. It was a little hairy, so I give him a little hair, but that was nice. Okay? Now, what about when they don't have common denominators. Well, we're going to flip the page and find out, right? So let's take 3/4 x plus 1/3 equals 11/24. Now there isn't a common denominator in sight. These are all very different. But I do notice that the least common denominator is 24. Because 4 times 6 is 24 and 3 times 8 is 24. And so the 24 is the least common denominator. So what I'm going to do is I am actually going to get rid of the fractions. Because trying to find each of the least common denominators is a little bit of work. There are some errors that can be made, and we're just much more experienced with dealing with integers. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to sprinkle some magic pixie dust over the top of this equation, and I'm going to put something in the numerator of each one of these. And what am I going to put in the numerator? I'm going to put the least common denominator. Put the least common denominator in the numerator of each fraction. Now, if you don't have a fraction, note, if no fraction for one of the terms, then just multiply by the term. Okay, because that's really what we're doing. All right, so if there's no fraction, then multiply by the term. But most of these things got fractions all over the place, so that's less of a concern. All right, so I'm going to sprinkle the 24 into the numerator of each of these. So what does that look like? 3 times 24 over 4x plus 1 times 24 over 3 is equal to 11 times 24 all over 24. Now, I put the 24 in here separate because I really didn't want to multiply 3 times 24. I didn't really want to multiply 11 times 24. And what happens is something very, very cool. If you look, you now have a division. You now have 24 divided by 4 right here. And 24 divided by 4 is 6. So you end up with 3 times 6, x. And if you look at this one right here, you've got 24 divided by 3, and that's 8. And so you just have 1 times 8. And then what you've got here is 24 over 24, and that's just 1. So you've got 11 times 1. And now all the fractions are gone. And this makes us happy, all right? Because now this is something we can deal with just a little bit easier. So now we're going to finish the problem. 3 times 6 is 18x. 1 times 8 is 8. 11 times 1 is 11, right? And so now we can go ahead and just undo our addition with a subtraction. So I'm going to subtract 8 from both sides. You're going to have 18x is equal to 3. And so now I'm going to divide by 18 on both sides. Why is that? Because we undo our multiplication with division, and I got to do it on both sides. So 18 over 18 is 1. 1 what? 1 times x. And 3 over 18 reduces to 1 6. And that's my final answer. The fraction pops up at the end, and it was fraction, so it was a little hairy. So I'll give them a little hair. But we got it done without any fractions. So that was great. So just to review, you can sprinkle the LCD into each term, all right, to get rid of fractions, all right, and you can use the multiplicative inverse to avoid complex fractions. And this will reduce your work and your number of errors. All right, so just look at this example a couple more times. Thank you very much. for watching. I'm Professor G, and you have a great day.